Let me ask you about this, because some people are asking about the credibility of this statement. Let's listen to what Kellyanne Conway had to say about these sanctions last night.
Some of them seem largely symbolic. The GRU doesn't really travel here, doesn't keep its assets here.
Is that correct? The GRU, from my understanding, does have assets here. They're covert.
They probably have certainly, I don't know how many, but they probably have a few official cover people in their Washington embassy, and as far as non-official cover, NOCs, which more and more intelligence services around the world are moving to, in spite of the danger of having someone who's not covered by a diplomatic immunity. Those are growing for many countries, and Russia has always used a fair number of NOCs because when they first came into existence back in 1917, right, they weren't recognized by anybody, so they couldn't have any official cover. So they started out, and as a result, a lot of the very effective Russian spies have been non-official cover people.
Well, Ambassador Woolsey, we appreciate your time. We know you'll continue to advise the president-elect and soon-to-be president, and you'll keep talking to us as well. Thank
Absolutely.
You very much, sir. We
Good
appreciate it. Waterfront mansion sitting on 45 acres, outfitted with a pool and tennis courts, a longtime retreat for Russian diplomats and their families. Now the Obama administration says this Maryland beachside compound, there it is right there, very nice, a luxury estate in New York as well. They're both spy nests, according to the U.S. government. Both compounds were shuttered this afternoon as part of the U.S. sanctions against Russia. CNN's Barbara Starr is at the Pentagon. Barbara, in 1992, the Associated Press ran a story about this retreat in Maryland in which one of the neighbors remarked that the Russians there made their steamed crabs differently than the locals. I hope they were using Old Bay, but otherwise seemed fairly normal. I guess that's the point, right?
Well, you know, the best spy nest maybe looks perfectly normal from the outside. This cat and mouse game between Moscow and Washington, of course, has been going on for decades. It's been immortalized in TVs and movies. But what we know is the reality can be vicious and violent. FBI cameras captured Russian operative Anna Chapman and a federal undercover agent meeting in a New York coffee shop in June 2010. 17 days later, Chapman and 9 other Russian sleeper agents were arrested in New York, New Jersey, and Virginia, charged with conspiracy to act as unlawful agents of Russia, spies who had burrowed deep into American society for years, trying to steal secrets and recruit agents. The FBI had watched Chapman and the others for months, recording drop-offs of packages, meetings on staircases, even one meeting just yards from CNN's offices in New York. The U.S. believes the group never got its hands on classified information, but the Russian infiltration into the U.S., a classic Moscow move.
What they do is more than just collect. They actually try to influence events to the benefit of Russia all over the world. And this is something that they have done for decades.
Within days at the airport in Vienna, an elaborately choreographed transfer. The 10 Russians traded back for 4 other Russians charged with being in touch with Western intelligence services. Now the State Department is expelling 35 Russian officials it says violated their diplomatic status. This after the U.S. claim of interference in the presidential election and harassment of U.S. diplomats overseas. Vladimir Putin, of course, a former Russian intelligence officer, well acquainted with the so-called illegals program, putting agents into U.S. society.
The fact that they would continue to do that, to establish these American, legends and cover story for these people who are trying to pose as Americans in the United States, shows how serious they are.
But the U.S. has also been caught in the act. In 2013, Ryan Fogel, a political secretary at the U.S. Embassy in Moscow, was arrested. The Russians claimed they caught him with wigs, dark glasses, and cash, trying to recruit a Russian agent. Fogel was expelled. It was never clear if he was set up by the Russians. Earlier this year, a U.S. diplomat was tackled and beaten by a uniformed Russian police officer as he tried to enter the American embassy in Moscow.
The action was unprovoked and it endangered the safety of our employee.
And in that latest incident, the U.S. wound up expelling two Russian diplomats. Jim?
Barbara Starr, thank you. After Republicans stripped him of key powers, an incoming governor takes his own legislature to court to get them back. The judge's ruling that just came down, that's next.